In this lecture, we'll discuss a few more properties of straight lines and matrix when the matrix A involved is essentially a n cross n real constant matrix. So, for the discussion, we'll have this where A belongs to n cross n real matrix space and is constant. Okay, so the first property we had already seen in one of the lectures is this phi a t comma tau is nothing but exponential of a multiplied by t minus tau. So this is the matrix exponential. It is essentially defined as k equal to 0 to infinity k to the power k t minus tau to the power k divided by k factorial. The second property is if you have the n cross n matrix differential equation where x of t is in the n cross n real matrix space and the initial condition that you have is nothing but identity, you have this, then x of t is e power a t minus t 0. Let's keep it simple. Okay. We consider t 0 to be 0 in this. Is this is a unique solution. Okay, so this is similar to what we had discussed in the previous lecture of properties for straight lines and matrices. Similarly, if z dot t is equal to minus a transpose z of t with z of 0 being the identity matrix and z of t belonging to the real n cross n real matrix space, then z of t is equal to e power minus a transpose t is a unique solution. Okay, so this is also something in line with what we discussed now when the matrix is tangent. For every t and tau, phi a t comma phi a t plus tau is this. This is nothing but e power a t multiplied by e power a tau. Okay. So similarly, if you have phi a t comma tau, this is e power a t minus tau, right? And this again can be written as e power a t product of e power minus a tau. Next, for every t, determinant of e power a t, where e power a t is the matrix difference, where e power a t is the straight lines and matrix, right? Nothing but e power trace of a multiplied by t. Next, for every t, e power a t inverse is nothing but e power minus a of t. So the inverse of the state transition matrix of a is nothing but the state transition matrix corresponding to minus a. Okay. So please note that the state transition matrix is invertible regardless of A. So if A is non-invertible or if A is invertible, doesn't matter, the state transition matrix is always invertible. Okay. In fact, this is true when A T is time varying. So in general, the state transition matrix, okay, what I am trying to say is phi A T comma tau is always invertible. State transition matrix is always okay. If P is an invertible constant n cross n real matrix, then for every t, e power p inverse p multiplied by t is same as p inverse e power a t multiplied by p. This is another property that we have. If A and F are n cross n real matrices and they are constant matrices, constant, then we have e power a plus f t is nothing but e power a t multiplied by e power f t for every t if and only if a f is equal to f t. Basically the two matrices a and f commute with each other. E power a t can be expressed as a finite summation series which is of this form. This comes from the Cayley-Hamilton theorem number 10. The Laplace transform of or rather I should write it like this. Of the matrix exponential e power a t is equal to si minus a inverse, the Laplace inverse of the matrix exponential. This is the state transition matrix. Okay, if a is in the block diagonal form. Let's say J1, J2, J3. The block diagonal form. Then for every t, e power a t is nothing but e power j1 t 0 0, e power a t t 0 0 0, e power j3 t. And so on. Okay, so we have considered J1, J2, J3. There are three blocks in the diagonal, so we have considered this. Okay. Next, for Jordan block J, which is of the form this. Okay, let the size be some n cross n. Okay, this Jordan block J can be written as, not use this, lambda into some identity matrix of the order m plus the special matrix n, where n is a matrix whose diagonals are 0 and the super diagonals are 1. Okay. So it is of this. This is how the Jordan block can be expressed as. And if you observe, multiplied by n is same as n multiplied by this. So there is a commutation, which means e power jt, state transition matrix corresponding to this Jordan block J, can be expressed as e power lambda im plus n multiplied by t, and since n and lambda im commute, I can write it as e power lambda im of t multiplied by e power n of t, where e power lambda im of t is essentially e power lambda t, e power lambda t. It's a diagonal matrix where all the entries are e power lambda t. Okay, diagonal matrix with all the entries in the diagonal as e power lambda t, and the e power n t matrix is such that the ijth entry of the n t matrix is t to the power j minus I by j minus I factorial for j greater than or equal to I and is 0, otherwise. Okay. To give a small example, if suppose j is of the form, let's say 2, 1, 0, 0, 2, 1, and 0, 0, 2, so I can express this as 2, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 0, 0, 2. This is the diagonal part. And then we have 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, and 0, 0, 0. So this is the N matrix. This is the lambda I M matrix. So e power lambda I M into T will be nothing but e power 2T 0, 0, 0, e power 2T 0, 0, 0, e power 2T, while e power nt will be 1 t square by 2 factorial, because here t is greater than equal to I. Now when we come to the second row, I is 2, j is 1, so it will be 0, then we will have 1 nt, and the next one will be this. This is what you have. So what is e power jt? E power jt is e power lambda imt multiplied by e power nt. If you multiply those two matrices, what we get is e power 2t t e power 2t t square e power 2t by 2 factorial. And you have 0 e power 2t, t e power 2t, 0, 0, and e power 2t. Okay, we'll stop here. Thank you.